Welcome to Yharnam. Welcome to the night of the hunt. And I can tell just by the amount of blood splattered upon your garb that the night has already introduced itself to you. You're lucky that I answered my door not too many Yharnamites would be so willing to do the same. And it has been quite a long, long time since I've had a guest. I was just preparing myself a little supper. Had I known a hunter like yourself was going to appear upon my doorstep, well, I would have prepared a feast for king or queen. Are you faring well? Let me see. Yeah. A minor wound. But nothing little. Blood can't fix, right? You must be hungry. Dress your wound. Well, an outsider, huh? I was once an outsider as well. And no doubt like yourself. Some bread. I'll leave it here for you on the table. As I was saying, I moved to Yharnam with my wife and my son. I thought that most likely the same reasons. That you arrived seeking a cure. Well, unfortunately, it was more than a cure that I found. How I miss you. I'm sure you have a lot questions, as I once did. And I'm sure you've already signed a contract with the Blood Minister. Since the night is so long, perhaps you can rest a spell. And I can tell you a tale of what became of Yharnam. You see, the city of Yharnam was not unlike any other in the realm. Children playing in the streets, merchants peddling their wares. We even had our own nobility and aristocrats nestled away in their nice, secluded castle. Before we get any further, how about a little toast? For what would a night of the hunt be? That a bit of the old yarn and blood. Oh, my own little concoction. Helps keep me going here at the end of my day. last for you. And a glass for myself. One must be careful not to get blood drunk. Now, where were we? Ah, yes. You have questions. Well, as I said, Yharnam was a city not unlike any other. What I'm about to tell you, though, is, some might say, mere speculation. What I've gathered when I hunted, although now I no longer dream. No one really knows for sure exactly what happened. We have only fragments. But I will do my best to try to answer questions that may be plaguing your mind. You don't want to touch any of your blood? Well, that's understandable. In due time. Aside from the everyday goings on in the city of Yharnam, there was perhaps the most important location, building, center. What they call Bergenworth. It is there where all of this came about. Tucked away past the forests in a secluded area, a peaceful location by the Moonside Lake. There sat this big potion for? I guess you would say higher learning. It was well known across the land for its findings in archaeology, history, and the studies of the human mind, wanting to push mankind further towards their evolutionary destiny. Scholars. There were many scholars that taught there, that learned there, and that set Yharnam on its path to hell. Of these scholars, there were a handful that were most notable for the events that occurred. Provost Willem, or Master Willem. He was the head of the academy. And then his apprentice, Lauren. Also esteemed among the scholars. There was also Carol, a runesmith, and then there was Mikalash, someone that may have once been known as Ram. And then perhaps even the first hunter, Gurman. And as they went about their studies, came upon a time during a archaeological dig that they found the old labyrinths beneath Yharnam, the crypts. If only they'd never ventured there. But so it came to be. These old labyrinths existed long before Yharnam, long before our species. They were built by an old race of beings. Called the Numerians, a race of human-like creatures, but of a far advanced civilization or intellect. And as the whispers and tales go, and what I could uncover, these old beings, they came into contact with these great ones, elder gods from another plane of existence, yet not far from where we live. And these Numerians began to communicate with these strange gods. They created sacred rites and chalice rituals. Something came to happen that set their civilization on the path to destruction. And so, these Numerians and their Queen Yharnam, hence the name of our city. They sealed the crypts, sealed the labyrinths, hid away their rites and their chalices, and they were never heard from or seen again. Thus the story, as I know. Until Provost Willem and his bloodthirsty acquaintances came upon the old crypts. What they found apparently was one of these elder gods, these great ones. I believe its name was Ebriatus, but I'm not too certain. They found this creature and thought that their mission at Bergenworth had come to fruition. So they extracted blood from this creature. They found the chalices, the rituals, and they began to study the blood of this great one. They began to experiment with it, the scholars at Bergen. You care for some more. You should get your strength. There. You have a long night ahead of you. Provost Willem wanted to study the blood. He wanted to line his brain with eyes to gain insight. He was interested in the evolution of our species through perhaps communing with these great ones. But his apprentice, Lawrence, wanted to use the blood to infuse it with our own. And that is when the House of Bergenworth became divided. Willem, Master Willem, did not want to use the blood as Lawrence did. And so, in an act of what Master Willem would say is treason, Lawrence left Bergenworth behind and went to form the Healing Church. And that is when the city of Yharnam was thrown under the reign of the church. Vicar Lawrence would become its headmaster, if you will. And blood ministration first began blood healing. And that is why you and I, and so many others, come to Yharnam, searching for our own cure, for whatever ails us. Master Willem would be left behind, locked the woods and the forest that would lead to Bergenworth would become known as the Forbidden Woods, guarded by a gatekeeper who kept a password to gain entrance. I have not seen Master Willem in so long, I do not know what has become of him. But what occurred next is what would set Yharnam down its path. Caused the plague of beasts. This blood that they began to use was corrupted in some way. And the visitors, the travelers, the outsiders, the citizens of Yharnam, in what is known as Old Yharnam, started to become infected by this blood, this intoxicating blood, this healing blood. And they began to turn into beasts. And it is thought that the healing church was not interested in healing after all, but experimenting to see if this blood could get them closer to these great ones, to become godlike, to evolve as so Vicar Lawrence thought would happen. Allow me to just move the blood, your glass. Sure, you'll be having your own later. And as the plague of beasts began to spread in what is known as Old Yharnam, the very first town or city, as I said, named after Queen Yharnam of the Numerians. The plague of beasts became too much. The outbreak spread faster than the healing church and Lawrence expected. And so it was that they called upon Gurman, the first hunter, to slay these beasts. But not, as far as I understand, until they burned Old Yharnam down. They enlisted these hunters called the Powder Kegs. Then they burn Old Yharnam to the ground, raise its buildings, and any people caught turned into beasts were also burned as well. Until one hunter by the name of Jura, he felt pity for these beasts, thought that they were still human. And so he became the guardian of Old Yharnam, and he is still there to this day, from what I know, ever vigilant, and he will hunt down any hunter who poses a threat to the beasts of Old Yharnam. He was part of the scourge beasts, or part of the raising of Old Yharnam, and he was met with great guilt. The first hunter, Gurman, created the hunter's workshop where you and I and so many other hunters forge their weapons and make other such necessities needed for the hunt. He was acquaintances with Willem, had respect for Willem, but was apparently ranked underneath him. Not sure if he was a scholar. He was also acquainted with Lawrence well. But Gurman broke off his relationship, I believe, except perhaps with Lawrence. Gurman, as you may not know, resides in the hunter's dream, the place where you go, or where your consciousness goes, when your physical body dies, and you are reborn until the hunt is over. But Gurman was the first hunter and taught many of the other hunters what they know, including the first healing church hunter, Ludwig. There would be many other hunters. Alfred. Ligarius, what is known as Martyr Ligarius. Even hunters of hunters, such as Eileen the Crow. For when the hunters would become overpowered by the blood, when the blood would take hold and they would become almost beasts themselves, Eileen the Crow and other hunters like hers would hunt down those hunters. Martyr Ligarius. A hunter who went after the aristocrats and nobles of Castle Canehurst, if you recall. I told you when we first began this little discussion. Castle Canehurst, set far off the coast of Yharnam, was home to many of these nobles, and they had a queen, Queen Annalise. And Queen Annalise was some form of beast or god or something. She was immortal, as the story goes, as the whispers say. She sought a child. What became of them? Well, someone from Bergenworth got a hold of some of the blood, corrupted blood, vile blood, and brought it to the Canehurst nobles, to Queen Annalise. I am not privy as to why. I can only surmise. But they all became, well, vile bloods, and they thirsted for the blood, for hunters and Yharnamites alike. They became bloodthirsty. And so Martyr Ligarius and his executioners went to Castle Canehurst and wiped them out, killed every single noble and aristocrat there, except for Queen Annalise, who could not be killed or was kept alive for other reasons. I'm not too sure, but after all of the residents of Castle Canehurst were killed, Martyr Ligarius donned this crown, and there, high atop Castle Canehurst, outside of Queen Annalise's chambers, he sits to this day, or his ghost does, ever watchful for anyone that would dare to try to reach the Queen. He keeps her in internal prison. The vile bloods. There's a whisper that says Queen Annalise may be of the Numerian bloodline. But after Castle Canehurst was razed to the ground, after old Yharnam burnt down, the plague of beasts just became too much for the healing church. And so Gurman, the first hunter, created the Hunter's Workshop. He apparently may have been involved with the Healing Church, but he split off. And it's he who helps guide the hunters to help bring this plague of beasts to an end. Ah, yes. Who was Master Willems? What did he used to say? Ah. We are born of the blood, made men by the blood, undone by the blood. Ah, so the Healing Church, with its first hunter, Ludwig, began to go after the beasts, and yet still performed the blood ministration. Garmin, the first hunter, helped train other hunters like myself, like you, help guide us to try and bring an end to these endless nights. They all thought the blood cure us, could heal us, could take us to the next stage of our evolutionary advancement, but they were all fools. They said the great ones, these elder gods, these beings from another world, try to have children with this surrogate human. But every child they have dies. Humans simply cannot bear their children. And therein, I believe, lies the answer, lies the final piece to this puzzle, but it is beyond me. As the blood that I need in my final days helps keep this old body alive, it also racks my mind. Strange visions and voices. So here you are, another hunter from the outside. Yeah, my wife and my son. We came to Yharnam, as did Father Gascoigne. My wife and son stricken with an illness that I would rather not discuss, but I thought blood healing would be the answer. Wow. As everyone has found out, that is far from the truth. Came of them. They became beasts. I watched my wife and my son slowly turn to the most horrible creatures I've ever witnessed in my life, and I had to put them down. Here I am, cursed now myself. That is why I find no problem in continuing to get blood drunk. And that is why it is time for you to depart. Lest one of us become the hunted. Well, I do appreciate you. Knocking upon my door this fine night. Before you go, allow me to share with you a few things that I no longer need. Many beasts ahead of you this evening. And it is best for you to be and it is best if you are utmost prepared. Antidotes left. Should you become poisoned, they say the people of old Yharnam were stricken with ashen blood. I say that the church poisoned them. All of this for the few mortals seeking power and greater knowledge. I have an eye rune that you may find useful. Some bone marrow ash. You may find more of this on your journey. But as I have mentioned, I am no longer in need of it in my condition. Perhaps you may find the use of this Numerian chalice. Here is some fire paper. Simply apply this to your weapon, and many of the beasts will cower at the sight of your fiery blade, or hammer, whatever it might be, cane. Last but not least, a blood vial. This should aid you as well. Well, my good hunter, fare thee well tonight. May you help us all to be freed from these endless nightmares. Freed from the dream, although I no longer dream. Hopefully this will be the last time that I will see you. I wish you all the very best. Yeah. in hunting, in uncovering the truth. But remember, fear the old blood.